तेरा बात था How to say? Topula?
Good.
Jakob?
Very good.
The
Fantastic.
Voila. Voila puna. Voila puna. Hare Krishna. The universal language, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
So, Radha Madhav, and then we have Kirtans. Yeah. Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra, Mahani, Ki.
Jagannath.
Gornitai, Ki.
Jagannath.
Vlad, Mishrede, Ki.
Jagannath.
Gary Govardhan, Ki.
Jagannath.
Shri Prabhupada ki
jai
Samaveda Bhaktivinoda ki
jai
Myself and Smita Krishna Maharaj were giving classes together in Ushantipur last week. I think we spent more time deciding on the topic than the entire length of the class. Right, we're trying to find the best topic. And it worked.
It
came out good.
totally spoke.
So today I spent 10 seconds picking the topics. So we'll see what happens.
Okay.
So this is from the fourth canto. 12th chapter. Text number 51. Om namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
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 This is the second to the last verse in the chapter called Dhruva Maharaj Goes Back to Godhead. Can you put this by the speaker? And this is more like a summary of the chapter, this verse. So I'll quickly just read the Sanskrit. And then we can do the word for word. Jnanam agyanti tadvaya yodayat sattvater mitam palayor dinatasya devatasya nugrinate jnanam. Knowledge. Agyatatvaya. To those who are unaware of the truth. One who. Dadya. In parts. Satpate. On the path of truth. Amritam.
Amritam.
Immortality. Kripalo. Kind. Dinanatasya. Protector of the poor. Deva. The demigods. Tasya. To him. Anugunate. Give blessings. So this is the benefit one gets from hearing this narration of Dhruva Maharaj's pastime. But it also gives some important practical instruction. The narration of Dhruva Maharaj is sublime knowledge for the attainment of immortality. Persons unaware of the absolute truth can be led to the path of truth. Those who, out of transcendental kindness, take on the responsibility of becoming master protectors of the poor living entities, automatically gain the interest and blessings of the demigods.
Priča o Dhruva Maharaji je uzvišeno znanje namijenjeno dostizanju besmrtnosti. Osobe koje nisu svjesne apsolutne istine mogu se dovesti na put istine. Oni koji iz transcendentalne ljubaznosti preuzmu odgovornost da postanu gospodari, zaštitnici javnih živih bića, samim tim privlače pažnju i stječu blagoslove polubogova.
So this, the purport is very long, so I'm only going to read a small section.
Obzirom da je smisao dugačak, pročitat ćemo samo jedan manji dio.
It says here, devotional service, this is somewhere halfway in the middle of the purport, it's in the about the fifth line down from the second paragraph. Devotional service, which leads to the association of the Supreme Lord, is actually immortality.
Predano služenje koje vodi do druženja sa svevišnjim gospodinom je u stvari besmrtnost.
Pure devotees, out of compassion for the fallen souls, are kripalu, very kind to people in general.
Iz samilosti prema palim dušama, čisti bhakti su kripalu, vrlo ljubazni prema ljudima uopće.
They distribute the Bhagavatam knowledge all over the world.
I šire ovo znanje Bhagavatama po cijelom svijetu.
A kind-hearted devotee is called Dinanath.
Dobrodušni bhakta se naziva Dinanath.
Protector of the poor.
Zaštitnik jadnih ljudi.
Ignorant mass of people.
U neznanju.
Lord Krishna is also known as Dinanath or Dinabandhu.
Gospodin Krishna je također poznat kao Dinanath ili Dinabandhu.
The master or friend of all the poor living entities.
Gospodar ili pravi prijatelj jadnih živih bića.
And his pure devotee also takes the same position as Dinanath.
A njegov čisti bhakta također preuzima isti položaj Dinanath.
The Dinanaths or devotees of Lord Krishna preach the path of devotional service, become the favorite of the demigods.
Dinanate ili bhakte gospodina Krishne koji propovijedaju put predanog služenja postaju miljenici polubogova.
Om akhyanti mirandasya gnanjana salakaya caksu unmilitamena tasmai shri gurave namaha shri chaitanya namavishtam stapitamena bhutale svayam rupa kadamayam kadanti svam kadantikam Vandeham Shiguro Shiyutapadakamalam Shigurum Vaishnavamscha Shirupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raganatam Vitantam Sajivam Sagaritam Sarvadutam Parijana Sahitam Krishna Chaitanya Devam Sri Radha Krishna Padam Sahagana Lalita Sri Vishakam Vitamscha Hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namostute Kapta Kanchana Gondangi Hare Yudha Vaneshwari Vrishalam Supra Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Pancha Kampa Tarupyascha Kripa Sindhu Devacha Vandhanam Bhavaneyo Vaishnaveyo Namo Ma Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Vrishnaya Bhutale Srimati Bhakti Vedanta Swami Namane Namaste Sarasvati Deve Gaudarani Pracharine Virvishesha Shunyavadi Prashyatya Deshatarine Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Srivatsari Om Bhaktivinoda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Those who have transcendental kindness take on the responsibility of becoming masters and protectors of the pure living entities automatically gain the interest and blessings of the devas.
Oni koji su iz transcendentalne ljubaznosti preuzeli odgovornost da postanu gospodari, zaštitnici jadnih živih bića, samim tim privlače pažnju i stječu blagoslove polubogova.
Word, one key word here is responsibility.
Ključna riječ ovdje je odgovornost.
Life means to take or accept responsibility.
Život podrazumijeva da trebamo prihvatiti odgovornost.
Parents are taking responsibility to raise the children.
Roditelji prihvaćaju odgovornost da odgoje djecu.
Father is taking responsibility to provide for the economic base of the family.
Očevi preuzimaju odgovornost da financijski
govern and getting whatever they need.
I u teoriji možemo reći da vladari države preuzimaju odgovornost da onima koji su im podređeni osiguraju sve što im je potrebno.
Life means responsibility.
Život znači odgovornost.
Either for ourselves, for our families, for our society, for our country, or maybe people want to take on a responsibility to help people around the whole world.
Bilo da preuzimamo odgovornost za sebe, za svoju zajednicu, društvo, obitelj, zemlju, ili postoje ljudi koji žele preuzeti odgovornost za čitav svijet.
So one cannot avoid responsibility without being condemned.
Odgovornost se ne može izbjeći bez da nas osude.
So the question is, what is our real responsibility? Or what is our primary responsibility?
I onda se postavlja pitanje koja je naša osnovna dužnost, koja je glavna dužnost.
Our primary responsibility is to become Krishna conscious.
Naša je glavna dužnost da postanemo svjesni Krishna.
Prabhupada would say human life means to become Krishna conscious.
Prabhupada je znao reći da ljudski život znači da trebamo postati svjesni Krishna.
And to live a life in a responsible way that Krishna consciousness becomes the result of one's life activities.
Trebamo živjeti odgovornim životom tako da posljedica toga bude razvijanje svjesnosti Krishna.
That's a great responsibility.
To je velika odgovornost.
When one understands what is the purpose of human life, one understands that there is some responsibility in order to achieve that purpose.
Kad osoba shvati da postoji svrha ljudskog života, onda razumije da ima i odgovornost da ju ostvari.
Responsibility is both activity and a state of consciousness.
Odgovornost je istodobno i aktivnost i stanje svijesti.
It's mostly a state of consciousness.
Uglavnom se radi o stanju svijesti.
As one understands that there's certain things I have to do and there's certain things I have to avoid to take responsibility for my spiritual growth.
Osoba razumije da postoje neke stvari koje treba poduzeti i neke koje treba izbjegavati kako bi prihvatila odgovornost za svoj duhovni rast.
So responsibility also contains the knowledge needed to carry out the goal of one's activities.
Odgovornost podrazumijeva i znanje koje nam je potrebno da bismo mogli ostvariti taj cilj svojih aktivnosti.
A purple person may be responsible in nature, but not knowing what to do may not achieve the goal, even though they make some effort.
Osoba koja je po prirodi odgovorna, ali ne zna što treba učiniti, neće nužno dostići cilj, iako se može truditi u tom smjeru.
So therefore, one part of becoming responsibility for the results of one's activity is becoming responsibility for what is needed to achieve the results.
Tako da jedan dio prihvaćanja odgovornosti za posljedice našeg djelovanja je prihvatiti i odgovornost za ono što nam je neophodno da bismo dostigli te rezultate.
Prabhupada said, take charge of your life and become Krishna conscious.
Prabhupada je znao reći prihvatiti. Uzmite svoj život u svoje ruke i postanite svjesni Krishna.
That is our first responsibility.
To nam je prva dužnost, odgovornost.
And we have responsibilities in this world also.
A imamo i druge odgovornosti u ovom svijetu.
They cannot be neglected.
Ni njih se ne smije zanemariti.
Taking care of the body.
Brinuti se o tijelu.
Taking care of children.
O djeci.
Taking care of economic needs in order to maintain the body and children.
O ekonomskim potrebama da bismo mogli održavati tijelo i djecu.
These are responsibilities too.
I to su odgovornosti.
But if we achieve success in that and we miss the primary responsibility of becoming Krishna conscious, then the scriptures say, Shrama eva hi kevalam, you've simply wasted your life.
Ali ako smo uspješni u ispunjavanju tih odgovornosti, a ne ispunimo glavnu odgovornost našeg života, ne postanemo svjesni Krišne, onda takvo djelovanje spisi opisuju kao Shrama eva hi kevalam, jednostavno smo protratili život.
So, that's a great responsibility to become Krishna conscious.
Velika je odgovornost postati svjestan Krišne.
Because when you're Krishna conscious, you help everybody.
Zato jer kad ste svjesni Krišne, onda pomažete svima.
One is Krishna conscious has achieved the success of all other activities simply by this one activity of becoming Krishna conscious.
Osoba koja je svjesna Krishne ujedno je dostigla uspjeh u svim drugim aktivnostima, samo tom jednom djelatnošću, postajanjem svjesni Krishne.
Because Krishna consciousness is real consciousness.
Jer je svjesnost Krishne zapravo prava svjesnost.
Any other consciousness that's not Krishna consciousness has been adopted due to our association with the material energy.
Svaka druga svjesnost koja se razlikuje od svjesnosti Krishne zapravo je nastala tako što smo se družili sa materijalnom energijom.
So Prabhupada would say, he wouldn't say do this or do that. He would say whatever you do, become Krishna conscious.
Prabhupada zato ne bi rekao radi ovo ili radi ono, nego bi rekao što god da činiš, postani svjestan Krishne.
In other words, avoid those activities that make you forget about Krishna conscious or make you forget about the goal of life.
Drugim riječima, izbjegavaju one aktivnosti koje te navode da zaboraviš na svjesnost Krišne ili da zaboraviš na cilj života.
And accept those things which are conducive to our practice of Krishna consciousness.
I prihvati one stvari koje pogoduju razvoju svjesnosti Krišne.
Responsibility.
Odgovornost.
Strong word.
Oštra riječ.
To be, we might break up the word respond to a situation.
Možemo riječ podijeliti na dva dijela, odgovoriti na neku situaciju.
It means to act properly to the situation.
To znači djelovati ispravno u skladu sa situacijom.
Or take on the difficulties of achieving success in whatever we do. Take on the difficult austerities.
Prihvatiti sve poteškoće koje se nađu na putu, a neophodne da bismo ostvarili ono što smo naumili.
So we all know that.
To svi znamo.
This is all basic stuff, right?
To je sve.
This is like bhakti yoga, you know, 1-1, the beginning, right? Become Krishna conscious.
Kao početak bhakti yoga, postani svjestan Krishna.
And we're trying to become Krishna conscious, right?
I pokušavamo.
Well, maybe some of us think there's more I could do to improve my Krishna consciousness.
Neki od nas možda misle ipak mogao bih još nešto učiniti da poboljšam svoju svjesnost Krishna.
But here is something else.
Ali ovdje objašnjeno još nešto.
And Prabhupada said this.
Prabhupada je to rekao.
He says there's two kinds of devotees.
Rekao je postoje dvije vrste bhakta.
One who's concerned only about their own spiritual progress.
Jedan koji zanima samo vlastiti duhovni napredak.
And one who's concerned about the spiritual upliftment and progress of others.
I drugi koji zanima uzdizanje, duhovno uzdizanje drugih i tuđi duhovni napredak.
Both are good.
I jedan drugi su dobri.
Both are glorious.
Slavni su.
Because anyone who takes up the process of Krishna consciousness is considered to be a great soul.
Zato jer se svakoga ko prihvati proces svjesnosti Krišne, smatra velikom dušom.
How many people take up spiritual life seriously?
Koliko ima ljudi koji se ozbiljno late duhovnog života?
Very few.
Jako malo.
Very few. So one who does is considered to be a very, very great personality.
Jako malo ima takvih ljudi. I zbog toga se onoga koji se stvarno prihvati duhovnog života smatra vrlo.
It doesn't matter what service they're doing, what their position is, what their body is. Simply because they've taken up Krishna consciousness seriously, they are called Mahatma. These are the words of Krishna.
Bez obzira kakvu službu obavlja, u kakvom je tijelu, gdje je, čime se bavi, ako je prihvatio se svjesnosti Krishne, naziva se Mahatmom. To su Krishnine riječi.
But then there's something else.
A onda imamo još nešto.
There's Maha Mahatma.
Onda ima i Maha Mahatma.
I just made up the word. Very, very great soul.
Jako, jako velika osoba.
And what does that mean?
A što to znači?
One who takes on the responsibility of giving Krishna consciousness to others.
To je onaj koji prihvaća odgovornost da drugima da svjesnost Krishne.
And that's what this verse is saying.
I o tome govori ovaj stih.
Says that one is recognized by the demigods.
Kaže da takvu osobu prepoznaju od polubogovi.
But Prabhupada adds that and says, one becomes immediately recognized by Krishna himself.
A Prabhupada još to dalje objašnjava i kaže,
is to give.
Dobiti znači dati.
You want to get something?
Želite nešto dobiti?
Give it.
Dajte to.
People say, nobody loves me.
Ljudi kažu, niko me ne voli.
Try loving somebody.
Pokušajte voliti
it comes back.
I vratit će vam se.
Right? If you wait, why doesn't anybody love you? Well, you can wait forever.
Ako mislite, zašto me niko ne voli, but onda možete do vijeka čekati.
If you show your love to others, it comes back.
Ali ako vi drugima pokažete svoju ljubav, onda će vam se vratiti.
Just, you know, if you want happiness,
Ako želite sreću,
give happiness to others.
Pružite sreću drugima.
If you have money and you want more money,
ako imate novca i želite još više novca,
spend it for others.
Potrošite ga na druge.
Whatever you get, whatever you give, you get.
Što god da dajete, to ćete dobiti.
It's the law of nature.
To je zakon prirode.
We're talking spiritually.
Sad govorimo o
duhovnom smislu. Materially, it doesn't always work like that. But there is some element of truth also there.
U materialnom pogledu to baš uvijek i ne funkcionira tako, iako postoji jedan element istine i u tom području.
The happiest people are people who are trying to give and not trying to get.
Najsretniji su oni ljudi koji pokušavaju dati, a ne dobiti nešto.
You might say, well, I'd have to get something in order to give something.
Netko bi mogao reći, ali trebam nešto dobiti da bih mogao dati.
And Prabhupada would also say, yes, you receive in order to get, and so you can get, so you can give. So getting is an opportunity for giving. So you have to get in order to give, but the goal is to give. And you get anyway.
Prabhupada je rekao da trebaš nešto dobiti da bi mogao dati, ali svrha tog dobivanja je da možeš davati i u tom slučaju uvijek dobivaš.
You give your time to Krishna?
Podate svoje vrijeme Krišni.
Give you more time.
Dajte mu još više vremena.
There's a saying, even in the material world.
I čak i u materialnom svijetu postoji uzrečica.
If you want to get something done, ask a busy person.
Ako želiš, ako trebaš nešto napraviti, zamoli za to nekog koji je jako zaposlen.
The person is not busy, you ask him what to do, they say, I got no time.
Ako osoba nije zaposlena jako, onda ako je zamoliš da nešto napravi, on će reći, nemam vremena.
But someone who's busy, they know the art of using time, and when you're busy for Krishna, Krishna expands time.
Ali osoba koja je zaposlena puno, onda ako je zamolite da nešto učini, ona zna kako upravljati vremenom, kako menadžirati to vrijeme i onda će uspjeti to napraviti.
Because time is his personal energy, and he can use it to expand it or to limit it.
Isto tako, ako radite nešto za Krišnu, Krišna je vlasnik vremena, vrijeme je njegova osobna energija, i on ju može proširiti ili suziti. Tako da ako želite nešto za njega napraviti, on će mu uvijek dati vremena.
This is the beauty of Krishna consciousness.
Tome je ljepota svjesnosti Krishna.
If you want, I just like I gave this lecture, not the same lecture, but something similar, about 3 weeks ago.
Nešto slično poput ovog predavanja koje sad držimo, održao sam prije 3 tjedna.
And so there was one devotee sitting there. I'm going to mention his name.
I tu je ispred mene bio jedan bhakta, neću spomenuti njegovo ime.
This was in Nushantipur in Kalabatsu.
To je bilo u Nushantipuru,
Kalabatsu. So I was saying, you know, if you give your money, you get more money.
I govorio sam o tome kako ako daješ novac, dobit ćeš natrag još više novca.
So when my lecture was over, he gave me 100 euros.
Kad je predavanje završilo, on je prišao i dobio 100 eura.
He said, I need some more money, so I'm some investment.
Rekao je, treba mi još novaca, tako da sad investiram.
I tried to explain, this wasn't my reason for saying this.
Pokušao sam objasniti da nisam zbog toga održao to predavanje.
I wasn't trying to get money through the lecture.
Nisam pokušao zaraditi s tim predavanjem.
He saw it as a good opportunity to increase his finances, so.
A on je uočio to kao dobru priliku da nešto, da poveća taj svoj priliv novca.
And since then, I think he's been doing better.
Mislim da mu tad bolje ide.
So this is how Krishna consciousness works.
Tako funkcionira svjesnost Krishna.
Of course, it's not so good to give with the idea of trying to get it back.
Naravno, nije baš najbolje davati novac s namjerom da ćeš dobiti natrag.
When one gives simply because it is the nature of the living being to give.
Osoba daje jednostavno zato jer je priroda živog bića da daje.
And Prabhupada said our movement is called Paropaka. Paropaka means one who wants to do good to others.
Prabhupada je rekao da se naš pokret zove para upakara, znači onaj koji želi činiti dobro drugima.
I mean, this is the symbol, the symptom of successful life.
To je jednostavno formula za uspješan život.
When the mother wants to do something good for the child, sometimes it's very difficult for the mother on her personal level, but she doesn't care because this is her happiness.
Ponekad kad majka želi učiniti nešto za dijete, to je može biti teško jer je u pitanju neka poteškoća koju se mora podvrći, ali nije važno, nije briga za to jer jedino misli na djetetovu sreću.
Doesn't it give you the greatest happiness when you do something for someone and someone really appreciates and says, thank you?
Zar vam ne pruža veliko zadovoljstvo kada nekome nešto učinite i to on stvarno cijeni i onda vam se zahvali.
You think it was worth it.
Odmah mislite kako je vrijedilo to što ste činili.
It goes right to the heart. It makes you feel satisfied and happy because you brought some happiness to somebody.
Odmah vas to dirne u srce jer ste nekoga usrećili.
But in Krishna consciousness, when you do that, you please Krishna, you please the demigods, and you please the whole world.
Ali u svjesnosti Krishna, kada to radite, onda zadovoljite Krishnu, polubogove i cijeli svijet.
Everyone is benefited.
Od toga svi imaju korist.
Materially, when you do something that's pleasing for someone, there's some benefit between the individuals involved. But in Krishna consciousness, because the activity is not limited to the people involved. It includes Krishna, the demigods, and everything connected with the Absolute Truth.
U materijalnom pogledu, kad nešto učinite, onda to obuhvaća samo te ljude koji su u pitanju. Ali kad činite neke spiritualne aktivnosti, onda se te aktivnosti šire ne samo na one koji su upleteni u taj događaj, nego s time zadovoljavate Krishnu, odnosno polubogove Krishnu, apsolutnu istinu.
So I started my lecture by saying, take responsibility to become Krishna conscious.
Započeo sam predavanje izjavom, prihvatite odgovornost da postanete svjesni Krishne.
But here's the key.
Ali sad ovdje je ključ.
You want to become Krishna conscious, give it to others.
Ako želite postati svjesni Krishne, dajte svjesnost Krishna.
And Krishna will give it to you.
I onda će Krishna svjesnost Krishna dati vama.
That's the key of becoming Krishna conscious.
To je ključ za postati svjestan Krishna.
You might say, I don't know much.
Možete reći, ali ja ne znam baš puno.
I'm a new devotee.
Ja sam početnik.
And I'm struggling also.
I sam se mučim još.
Okay, fine.
Dobro, u redu.
But, whatever you know, whatever you've heard, whatever little bit you've gained so far, give it.
Ali što god da znate, što god da ste naučili, to malo što ste prikupili, dajte to.
Just to be kind to people is devotional service.
Već samo ako ste ljubazni sa ljudima, to je predano služenje.
Sometimes people say, well, that's material to be kind. It's like, it's not transcendental.
Ponekad ljudi u materijalnom pogledu nastoje biti ljubazni, to nije transcendentalno.
I'm so transcendental, I have no time to be kind.
Nekad mislimo, toliko sam transcendentalno da nemam vremena da budem ljubazan prema drugim.
I'm absorbed in transcendence, so don't bother me about anything else.
Uronjen sam u transcendenciju, zato me ne bi smetati sa čim.
Yeah, it's like that sometimes.
Ponekad se to čuje.
But the idea is that out of the 26 qualities of a Vaishnava, which are the characteristics of a Vaishnava, number one quality is kindness.
Ali zapravo od 26 osobina Vaishnave koje karakteriziraju Vaishnavu, osobina broj 1 je ljubaznost.
When someone's kind to you, they're grateful.
Kad je netko ljubazan, blag prema vama, osjećate zahvalnost.
So, we do that to others, how they feel the same way.
Znači, kad se mi tako prema drugima ponašamo, onda se i oni tako osjećaju.
Prabhupada used kindness to preach Krishna consciousness.
Prabhupada je koristio ljubaznost, blagost da bi propovjedao svjesnost Krishne.
He did it a lot.
Puno je to
činio. Not as a means for preaching, but just because that's the nature of a Vaishnava, to be kind to others.
I to nije bilo neke sredstvo propovjedanja, sredstvo koje je koristio za propovjedanje, već je to jednostavno biti na različite načine.
Doing something that a person likes and they get some benefit from the thing that you offer them, that's one form of kindness.
Ako učinite nešto što se osobi sviđa i ako će ona dobiti neku korist od toga nakon što to učinite, to je jedna vrsta ljubaznosti.
Another form of kindness is giving something they need, although they may not like it.
Druga vrsta ljubaznosti je ako osobi date nešto što je potrebno, ali se možda to i ne sviđa.
Little tougher, right?
To je već malo teže, ne?
I mean, if parents let their children do everything they want, is that called kindness?
Ako roditelji dozvole djeci da rade sve što ona žele, može li se onda reći da su prema njima ljubazni?
It's more like foolishness.
Prije glupost.
And the child doesn't exactly know what to do for their own benefit, so there's guidance and correction and sometimes reprimand.
I obzirom da dijete zapravo ne zna što je dobro za njega, zato ga treba voditi, ispravljati, a ponekad i kazniti.
But that's love.
Ali to je ljubav.
If you're always telling everybody the good things and don't tell them what they need, you're not really their friend.
Ako uvijek drugim ljudima govorite lijepe stvari, a ne kažete im ono što im je potrebno, zapravo baš niste prijatelji.
So preaching sometimes means to tell somebody or give somebody something hard for them to understand or even to accept.
Propovjedanje podrazumijeva da ćete ponekad nekome dati nešto što im je teško razumjeti pa i prihvatiti.
But still we do it.
Ali ipak to činimo.
And we all should do it because we know this is a way to help another.
To činimo i zato jer znamo da im na taj način pomažemo.
But there's an art to it.
Ali postoji umijeće kako to činiti.
The art is to do it in such a way that people like what you're giving them, at the same time don't like what you're giving them, but like to receive it.
Umijeće je da kad se ljudima ne sviđa to što im daješ, ipak im se sviđa način, sviđa im se da to prime, sviđa im se način.
It hurts, but I know it's good.
Oh, boli me, ali znam da je dobro.
Right? It's like that. I'll tell you a little story.
Ispričat ću vam malu priču.
I think you've probably heard this story before.
Vjerojatno ste već čuli.
This was back when Hare Krishna was first beginning in that, and I think this was in Europe, actually.
Mislim da se to dogodilo negdje na početku pokreta u Europi.
So there was hardly any congregation. Most of the temples, most of the devotees were temple devotees.
Skoro da i nije bilo kongregacije, većina bhakta su živjela u hramu.
In fact, if anybody over 30 walked into our temple, it was kind of quite rare.
Bilo je vrlo rijetko da se u hramu pojavi netko koji je bio stariji od 30 godina.
We were attracting young people.
Privlačili smo mlade ljude.
And we were encouraging them to join the temples.
I podsticali smo ih da nam se pridruže, da dođu živjeti u hram.
And even if they got married, they lived in the temples.
I čak i ako bi se oženili, živjeli u hramu.
In the early days it was like that. There was hardly any congregation.
Na početku je to tako izgledalo, jedva da je bilo neke kongregacije.
So we were kind of like, what we say, what's the word? Ignorant of the outside world.
Tako da smo u neku ruku nismo marili puno za vanjski svijet.
A little bit oblivious, might I also say.
Jednostavno smo bili
uzvaljeni
od toga, nesvjesni.
One lady came.
I došla jedna gospođa tamo.
And she came first time into the temple.
Prvi put je došla u hram.
She had read some books that the devotees had given her.
Pročitala je neke knjige koje je dobila od bhakta.
And she was inspired to come to the temple.
I odlučila je da dođe u hram.
Now she liked to dress in a certain way.
Sviđalo je se odjevati se na određen način.
Mini skirts.
Kratka suknja.
And her hair like way up there.
Kosa tako s frizurom na široko na glavi.
All kinds of lipsticks and perfumes. She smelled very nice.
Parfemi, ruž za usne. Jako je fino mirisala.
Yeah, so when the devotees saw her, they thought, she's not dressed for temple.
Kad su je bakte vidjeli, onda su pomislili, a ovo nije odjeća za hram.
So they told her, we like you coming, but you can't dress, come like that, dress like that.
I onda su joj rekli, drago nam je da dolaziš, ali nije baš dobro da se ovako odjevaš.
It's not nice in front of the deities.
Nije lijepo da tako dolaziš pred božanstva.
But she just listened and didn't like what they said. So next time she came, same way. The devotees got a little stronger. She came again the next time. This time they really got heavy with her. And she decided, I'm not going anymore. So she stopped going. And then just after that, Prabhupada was scheduled to visit that temple.
I skoro nakon toga predviđalo se da će Prabhupada posjetiti taj hram.
Sissy heard, oh, the guru is coming, let me go meet the guru.
I onda je ona čula, aha, guru dolazi, idem tamo da se sretnem guru.
She really got attracted to reading Prabhupada's books.
Zaista se joj prevuklo čitanje Prabhupada knjiga.
So Prabhupada came, and it was a Sunday feast lecture, and Prabhupada just took his seat on the Vyasa side.
Došao je Prabhupada, bilo je to predavanje za, na Sunday Feastu i samo što je sjeo na Vyasasan.
And she walks in.
Kad je ona ušla u hram.
Dressed the same way.
I ona je na isti način.
And she's looking for a place to sit.
I osvrnula se naokolo da vidi gdje bi mogla sjesti.
Prabhupada notices her.
Prabhupada je primijetio.
He says, thank you for coming, you look very nice today.
Hvala ti što si došla, danas si želeš jako lijepo.
You can imagine how she felt.
Možete zamisliti kako se osjećala.
She sat down, listened to the whole lecture.
Sjela i poslušala je cijelo predavanje.
Later she said, your teacher is very nice.
Je rekla, vaš učitelj jako fin.
That night, or maybe a night, sometime after, she decided take her hair down, wear regular skirts, get rid of the makeup. She said, if this pleases the devotees, then this is what I'll do.
Kratko vrijeme nakon tog susreta sa Prabhupadom, odlučila je kompletno promijeniti svoj izgled i prilagoditi se onome što su bhakte tražili od nje.
The devotees couldn't reach her by heavy preaching.
Bhakte nisu uspjeli doprijeti do nje s tim oštrim propovjedanjem.
Prabhupada didn't see the body, he saw her as a spirit being.
Prabhupada nije vidio tijelo, vidio je nju kao duhovnu dušu.
He related to her like just the way she could accept.
I ophodio se prema njoj baš na takav način koji je ona mogla prihvatiti.
And then her heart was touched.
I to je dirnulo.
And she wanted to please the devotees, so she made that change.
I onda je poželjela ugoditi bhaktama i zato je promijenila odjeću.
This is a story that happened many, many years ago, but it illustrates preaching according to time, place, and circumstance.
Ta se priča dogodila prije puno, puno godina, ali pokazuje kako propovijedati u skladu sa vremenom, mjestom i okolnostima.
We speak in different ways, but the goal is somehow to make a person come closer to Krishna.
Možemo govoriti na različite načine, ali cilj toga je da osobu nekako približimo Krishni.
So, in our own practice,
u svom duhovnom životu,
we must see what does it mean for me to make, what is my next step to become a devotee.
Moramo uočiti koji je to sljedeći korak koji trebamo poduzeti da postanemo bhakta.
What do I have to do to make advancement in spiritual life?
Što trebamo učiniti da napredujemo u duhovnom životu?
I have to stop doing that is not helping me in my Krishna consciousness.
Ili što trebam prestati raditi, što mi ne pomaže u mojoj svjesnosti Krishna.
That one's a little harder.
To je već malo teže.
Because sometimes we get into these patterns and they somehow stick with us and they're hard to get rid of. And they're not healthy patterns.
Ponekad počnemo djelovati po nekim obrascima koji nisu baš zdravi za nas, ali nam je teško iz toga se izvući.
So that's a nice prayer.
Ovo je jako lijepa molitva.
My dear Lord.
Dragi moj gospodine.
Or my dear spiritual master.
Ili dragi moj duhovni učitelju.
I'm falling in this material world.
Pao sam u ovaj materijalni svijet.
I think I'm all right.
Mislim da sam u redu.
And that's my problem.
I to je moj problem.
Please help me progress towards your lotus feet.
Molim te, pomozi mi da napredujem do tvojih lotusnih stopa.
One devotee asked me a question the other day.
Neki dan na jedan bhakta pitao.
About, if we don't have a desire for the right thing, then what do we do?
Ako ne želimo ono što je za nas ispravno, što trebamo onda učiniti?
I don't have a desire to associate with devotees.
Ne želim se družiti s bhaktama.
But I know I should.
Ali znam da bih trebao.
But the desire is not there.
Ali želje nema.
So what do I do?
Što da radim?
Pray for the desire to desire.
Moli se da dobiješ želju da to želiš.
My dear Lord, give me the desire to have the desire to associate with the devotees.
Dragi moj gospodine, molim te, daj mi želju da poželim družiti se s bhaktama.
And Krishna will hear that. Because it's related to your spiritual progress.
Zato je povezano sa vašim duhovnim napretkom.
So this is a nice way to pray.
To je lep način molitve.
Prayers are powerful.
Molitve su moćne.
Very powerful.
Jako moćne.
Even though we chant japa.
Čak i kad mantramo na japu.
We should pray to the Lord, my dear Lord, please give me the proper attitude where I can take shelter of your holy name.
Dragi gospodine, molim te da omogući mi da imam pravi stav, tako da mogu uzeti stati pod okrilje tvog svetog imena.
So praying to have the desire that is beneficial is actually one of the best forms of prayer.
Jedna od najboljih oblika molitve je molitva u kojoj se molimo da dobijemo želju koja je povoljna za nas.
Back in the old days, again, going way back again.
Davno tamo na početku pokreta.
Maybe Maharaj remembers these things, but devotees would say, I want to be a pure devotee.
Možda se Maharaj toga sjeća. Bhakta bi znali reći, želim biti čisti bhakta.
Krishna, take everything away.
Krishna, sve odnesi, uzmi sve.
Make me your pure devotee.
Čini me svojim čisti bhakta, tvojim čisti bhakta.
And they would pray like that.
Tako bi se molili bhakta.
And then Krishna would start taking everything away.
Onda bi Krishna počeo sve oduzimati.
And he said, whoa, wait a minute, not so fast.
Onda bi bhakta rekli, hey, čekaj malo, ne tako brzo.
Let me change that prayer.
Daj da promijenim molitvu.
Yeah, I used to see that. So, you know, devotees used to say, why would I be a pure devotee? But they didn't know what it meant.
Znao sam ja to ponekad svjedočiti tome. Bhakte bi rekli, želim biti čisti bhakta, ali zapravo nisu znali što sve to podrazumijeva.
But if you pray like that,
ali ako se tako molite,
it works.
Funkcionira.
Are you ready?
Jeste li spremni?
But Krishna is kind.
I Krishna je ljubazan.
He doesn't put us in a situation where we're get bewildered.
Ne stavlja nas u situaciju gdje ćemo se zbuniti.
He generally moves us one step at a time.
Obično nas vodi korak po korak.
But we shouldn't stand still.
Ali mi se ne smijemo tu ukovati.
Or go backwards.
Ili se vratiti natrag.
That, therefore then Krishna comes in the form of the spiritual master or in the form of material energy to give us a little push.
I onda se Krishna pojavi u obliku duhovnog učitelja ili materijalne energije da bi nas malo gurnuo.
And that's good.
To je dobro.
You want that.
To želimo.
A little push.
Malo da nas gurne.
And we should also push others.
A i mi trebamo gurati druge.
In a nice way.
Na lijep način.
Kindly push.
Ljubazno gurati.
But push.
Ovako, ali gurati.
I mean, to push, you really have to have some connection with the person you're pushing.
Da bi neko mogli tako gurkat, morate imati neku vezu s tom osobom.
Because the more you're connected, the more it's easier for people to accept what you have to offer.
Jer što ste više povezani, to je ovoj drugoj osobi lakše prihvatiti ono što možete vi ponuditi.
It's like a stranger tells you what to do, you don't take it much importance because you don't have any relationship with that person.
To je kao kad vam neki stranac kaže što da učinite, to vam baš puno ne znači jer nemate neki odnos s njim.
So as we develop relationships, we also develop the opportunities to help others.
Tako da razvijanjem međusobnih odnosa razvijamo i prilike da drugima pomognemo.
A devotee is a well-wisher of everyone.
Bhakta je dobro namjer misli.
He wants everyone to be happy.
On želi da svi budu sretni.
Prabhupada said, what is that verse? Let's see. Sukanti bhavanti, sukena bhavanti. You know that one? Sarva suketu bhavanti. Sarva suketu bhavanti means let everyone be happy. Well, we usually use that verse on marriage ceremonies.
Obično taj stih koristimo pri vjenčanjima, obredu vjenčanja.
When we give marriage lectures, we usually say sarva suketu bhavanti. May you become happy.
Tako, ljudima u toku tog obreda vjenčanja zaželimo postanite sretni, želimo vam da postanite sretni.
But that's a general statement. It means that a devotee wishes everyone happiness.
To je općenita izjava, znači da bhakta svima želi da budu sretni.
And the devotee makes efforts to make others happy.
I potrudi se da druge usreći.
But again, happiness means to give what people need and not so much what they want.
Ali treba imati na umu da sreća znači da ljudi dobiju ono što im je potrebno, a ne baš nužno ono što žele.
So it's easy when you want Krishna consciousness because whatever you get, you need.
Lako kad želiš svjesnost Krishna, jer sve što ti je potrebno, to dobiješ.
But if you don't want Krishna and somebody tries to give you, you think,
Ali ako ne želiš Krishnu, a netko ti ga pokušava dati, onda nisi baš jako sretan.
So we want Krishna.
I želimo Krishnu.
Prabhupada said, if you get Krishna, you get everything.
Prabhupada kaže, ako dobijete Krishnu, dobijete sve.
Because Krishna is everything.
Jer Krishna je sve.
A person who owns everything and controls everything, if you get that person's favor, you also get the benefit of what he has.
Osoba koja sve ima, koja je vlasnik svega i koja svime upravlja, ako ona postane blagonaklona prema vama, onda i vi imate koristi od svega toga čime ona raspolaže.
But the thing is, when you get Krishna, you don't want anything else.
Ali stvar je u tome da kada vidite Krishnu, više ništa ni ne želite.
Because we want so many other things because we don't have Krishna.
I zapravo želimo tolike druge stvari zato jer nemamo Krishnu.
And the more we get Krishna, the less we want so many other things.
Što više Krishna dobijemo, to manje želimo druge stvari.
This movement is very dangerous.
Ovaj pokret jako opasan.
Very dangerous.
Jako opasan.
Yeah. It says, don't go.
Kaže, ne idi.
Rupa Goswami speaks.
Rupa Goswami kaže.
Don't go.
Ne idi.
Don't go down to the banks of the river Jumna.
Ne idi dolje na obale rijeke Jamune.
And see that beautiful boy standing in threefold bending form.
I ne gledaj tog prekrasnog dječaka koji tamo stoji povijen na tri mjesta.
Dressed in beautiful yellow garments with a peacock feather.
Odjeven u predivnu žutu odjeću sa paunovim perom.
Don't go.
Ne idi tamo.
He's smiling.
Smiješi se.
He's playing on the flute.
Svira na flauti.
It's dangerous.
Opasno je.
You'll lose everything.
Sve ćeš izgubiti.
Don't go.
Maybe.
Okay. That's Krishna.
To je Krishna.
He doesn't have to take everything away.
On nam ne mora sve oduzeti.
If you just get Krishna, you don't want anything else.
Ako dobijete Krishnu, više ništa ni ne želite.
Because everything is there in Krishna and more.
Jer u Krishni je već sve to i puno više.
Therefore, it's called, when Prabhupada began his movement in New York City in 1965, he got a little storefront, which was a little curio shop before, knick-knack shop, souvenir shop.
Prabhupada je na početku započeo, kad je započinjao ovaj...
And the shop had a name, it was called the Matchless Gift.
I trgovina ta je imala svoj naziv, zvala se Neprocjenjiv dar.
So the devotees were fixing up the store.
I bhakte su popravljali tu
trgovinu. And they wanted to take the sign down.
I htjeli su skinuti taj stari naziv.
Prabhupada said, no, leave the sign up.
Prabhupada je rekao, ne, ostavite taj naziv.
This describes our movement.
Taj naziv odlično opisuje naš
pokret. Giving that gift that cannot be matched.
Dajemo im poklon koji je neprocjenjiv.
Krishna.
Krishna.
So this is the conclusion.
To je zaključak.
Become Krishna conscious.
Postanite svjesni Krishne.
Give Krishna to others.
Dajte Krishnu drugima.
That's all.
To je sve.
Just figure out how to be responsible and do that.
Otkrijte samo kako da budete odgovorni i da to činite.
Do it amongst ourselves.
Činimo to među nama.
The association of devotees means to inspire each of us and our Krishna consciousness.
Druženje s bhaktama znači međusobno se poticati na razvoj svjesnosti Krishne.
The association of devotees means to take the opportunity to inspire ourselves by serving others.
Društvo bhakta znači prihvatiti priliku da sam sebe nadahneš tako što ćeš služiti drugim.
There's another trick to getting rid of material life.
Ma još jedan trik kako se riješiti materijalnog
života. Shall I tell you that trick too?
Da vam to kažem?
Yes, of course.
This is a hard one. But it works. Prabhupada was giving a lecture. I'll tell it in the form of a story. And this was in India, and so many important political people came to hear Prabhupada.
To je bilo u Indiji i puno je vodećih ljudi iz političkih krugova došlo čuti Prabhupada.
This was back in the early part of the movement, late 1960s.
To je bilo tamo na početku pokreta, negdje na kraju 60-ih godina.
So at the end of the lecture, one very big, highly placed government minister, he came to Prabhupada, paid full obeisances, laid flat on the ground, touched Prabhupada's feet.
Na kraju predavanja Prabhupada je prišao jedan visoko pozicionirani vladin dužnosnik, ispružio se pred njim u dandavatu i dotakao mu stopala.
And so the devotees were looking, wow, Prabhupada, that's amazing, this person, he's such a big person.
I bhakti su bili zapanjeni, gledali su, Prabhupada, ova nevjerovatna, ova neka velika riba, ovaj čovjek.
So they asked Prabhupada after, what is it about you that attracts people?
I onda su poslije toga pitali Prabhupada, što je to u tebi što privlači takve ljude?
Prabhupada said, I have no time. Okay. No, he said, I'm sorry, I have no lust. I have no lust.
Prabhupada je rekao, ja ne osjećam nikakvu požudu.
And then he left.
I otišao.
So the devotees thinking, oh my God, we're so lusty.
Bhakti su rekli, oh ne, mi smo tako požudni.
Prabhupada knows that doesn't have any lust.
Prabhupada uopće ne osjeća
nikakvu požudu. Got in his car. The boys got in the car with him.
Prabhupada je ušao u auto i neki bhakti su ušli s njim.
They were driving to the for Prabhupada's stays.
Vozili su se tamo gdje je Prabhupada odsjeo.
And it was quiet.
Svi su šutili.
Everyone's thinking about what Prabhupada said.
Svi su razmišljali o tome što je Prabhupada nekom rekao.
And Prabhupada could sense that.
Prabhupada je to osjetio.
So, and when he got out of the car after he reached his place, he turned around and looked at the devotees and he spoke.
I onda kada su došli do tog mjesta gdje je Prabhupada odsjeo, izašao je iz auta, okrenuo se prema bhaktama i rekao.
He said, it's not because I have no lust, it's because I have no time.
I onda im je rekao, nije to zato jer ne osjećam požudu, nego zato jer nemam vremena.
Don't give any time to Maya.
Nemojte Maji posvetiti ni malo vremena.
If you're so busy with Krishna, there's no time for Maya.
Ako ste toliko zaokupljeni za postup s Krishnom, onda nema vremena za Maju.
Jai Shri Shri Gornatari ki jai. Jai Shri Jagra Paladeh Subhaja Maharani ki jai. Paradna Shringa Deva ki jai. So that's another way to become Krishna conscious. Just fill your day up with Krishna conscious activities and just have no time for Maya.
To je još jedan način da postanete svjesni Krishne. Jednostavno ispunite dan aktivnostima povezanim sa svjesnošću Krishne i onda nemate ni vremena za Maju.
Tough one, but we can do it.
To je malo teže, ali može se napraviti.
Make a schedule.
Unaprijed planirajte.
And if you can't make it, ask your spiritual master to give you a schedule.
Ako ne možete sami isplanirati, onda zatražite od svog duhovnog učitelja da on za vas napravi dnevni raspored.
Happy to give you a schedule.
On će biti sretan da vam da dnevni raspored.
That way we can keep busy.
Tako možete biti uvijek
zaposleni
s nečim za Krishna.
And then Maya goes away.
I onda Maya odlazi.
Yes.
Da.
Who's there?
Ko je to?
It's me, Maya.
Ja sam Maya.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm busy right now. Come back tomorrow.
Oh, žao me, imam puno posla. Sad dođi sutra.
Yes?
Da?
It's me, Maya. You told me to come back tomorrow, so I'm here.
Ja sam Maya. Juče si mi rekao da dođem sutra. Evo me, tu sam.
Yeah, but I said tomorrow, so tomorrow.
Da, rekao sam sutra. Sutra dođem.
Tomorrow never comes. It's always today.
Nikad nije sutra, uvijek je danas.
So, yeah, we just keep pushing Maya off. I have no time for Maya.
Jednostavno tako odgurnemo Maya. Nemam vremena.
Too many things to do for Krishna.
Toliko stvari za obaviti za Krishna.
That's one way. That's a very powerful way.
To je jedan vrlo moćan način.
But, of course, the best way is to fill our day with chanting the holy names and serving the Vaishnavas.
Najbolji način je da ispunimo dan mantranjem svetog imena i služenjem Vaishnava.
Service to the Vaishnavas is taking responsibility for spreading Krishna consciousness.
služenje Vaishnava je preuzimanje odgovornosti za širenje svjesnosti Krishne.
Krishna says, one who is a my devotee, not my devotee. One who is a devotee of my devotee is actually my devotee.
Krishna kaže, onaj tko kaže da je moj bhakta, nije moj bhakta. Ali onaj tko je bhakta mojih bhakta, ta je moj bhakta.
Krishna is pleased when we serve those who are connected with him.
Krishna je zadovoljan kada služimo one koji su s njim povezani.
And we try to serve Krishna directly, it's difficult.
A ako ga pokušavamo neposredno služiti, to je onda teško.
And so, serving Vaishnavas, and giving Krishna consciousness to others.
Davanje svjesnosti Krishna drugima.
And your life will be happy.
I život će biti sretan.
That's why Krishna Prabhupada said, Krishna consciousness is happy life.
Zato je Prabhupada govorio, svjesnost Krishna je sretan život.
There's no work.
Ne radi se.
Prabhupada, but we're doing so many things. There's no work.
Ali Prabhupada, mi toliko toga radimo. Ne radi se.
We have this to do, that to do. It's not work.
Prabhupada, ali moramo napraviti ovo i ono i ovo. To nije posao.
It's chanting, dancing and feasting.
To je mantranje, pjevanje, plesanje i gozba.
When one sees any activity they have to perform as simply an opportunity to please Krishna, that's wonderful.
Kada čovjek može svaku aktivnost koju treba obaviti vidjeti kao priliku da ugodi Krišni, onda je to prekrasno.
It can be the smallest little thing like cleaning something.
Može biti neka najbeznačajnija stvar kao neko čišćenje.
Or could be a big thing like organizing a Ratha Yatra.
Ili može biti velika stvar kao što je organizirati Ratha Yatru.
It doesn't matter.
Nije važno.
Whatever you do, put your heart into it, put your attention into it, and put your life into it, if you can.
Nije važno što god da je, stavite u to srce, svoju pažnju i čitav život zapravo.
We want to go back to Godhead.
Mi se želimo vratiti natrag Bogu.
Does anybody want to stay in this world? Anybody?
Da li neko ovdje tko želi ostati u ovom svijetu?
Is that your hand is up? You don't want to stay. You want to stay? To preach.
Želiš ostati ovdje? Da propovijeda.
No, we don't want to stay in this world.
Ne, mi ne želimo ostati.
Because if you die, you gotta come back and you have to be born again. And you have to take, you have to be a baby and you pass through in your diapers, the whole thing.
Jer ako umreš i ponovo se moraš ovdje roditi, onda ćeš biti malo beba i morat ćeš kakati u pelene.
So, you know, you have to go through that whole mess again.
Kroz sve to tu gnjavažu moraš ponovo proći.
Prabhupada would say, finish in this life.
Prabhupada bi sad ovaj život sve sredite do kraja.
And if you don't, you pick up from where you left off next life.
Ako ne uspije, sljedeći život ćete nastaviti tamo gdje ste ovaj stali.
You may say that's good.
Možete reći da je to dobro.
But,
ali,
here's the but.
Ali,
whatever is holding you.
Ovaj život, sa istim tim ćete se suočiti sljedeći život.
Get rid of it now.
Bolje da se odmah toga
whatever it is.
Odreknete, što god da je.
Envy.
Zavis.
Anger.
Gnjev.
Lust.
Požuda.
Laziness.
Lijenost.
Intolerance.
Nesnošljivost.
No taste for chanting.
Nemam ukusa za mantranje.
Too much television.
Previše televizije.
Whatever it is, get rid of it now.
Što god da je, odreknite se toga sad.
It's easy.
Lako je.
Krishna, take away my television.
Krishna, molim te, oduzmi mi televiziju.
And somebody will come and steal it.
Ošalje neko ko dođe i ukrade ju.
Or even if you just give it away, it's easier.
Ili je možda lakše da jednostavno sam daš nekom.
So anything that's blocking us, just get rid of it.
Sve što nas zaustavlja, jednostavno se riješite toga.
Because each time we get rid of a block, it's like getting over a disease.
Svaki put kad se riješimo tako nekog nečeg što nas zaustavlja, to je kao da smo preboljeli neku bolest, da smo se izliječili bolest.
And that's why we have the spiritual master to tell us exactly what we need, when we need it, and how to get rid of it.
I zato nam treba duhovni učitelj, da nam kaže točno što nam treba, kako nam to treba i kako ćemo to napraviti.
The spiritual master comes to bring you to Krishna.
Duhovni učitelj dolazi da bi nam donio Krishnu.
He's not here to flatter you.
On nije ovdje zato da, da bi vam laskao.
How nice you are.
Da bi vam rekao kako ste dobri, fini.
Although you are very nice.
Jer vi jeste fini.
But he's here to give you the medicine to go back home, back to Godhead.
Ali on je tu zato da vam da lijek pomoću kojeg ćete se vratiti natrag ući Bogu.
The disease is material life.
Bolest je materialistički način života.
I think there's a term in Croatia, it's called Bavaro. Bavaro? Bavaroga. Ah. Bavaroga. She's not there. Bavaroga.
Postoji taj izraz u hrvatskom Bavaroga.
In Sanskrit, that means material disease.
Sanskrit to znači materialistička bolest.
Yeah, so it's very good. You have a very good language. Get rid of Bavaroga.
Riješite se Bavaroge.
Stay away from her, she's a witch.
Klonite se.
Baba Asuda. Asudi. Baba Asudi. Baba Asudi means the medicine to destroy Bavaroga. Asudi.
Baba
Asudi
je...
Asaudi? Aušadi. Aušadi, okay.
Baba Aušadi je lijek kojim ćemo se riješiti Bavarogi.
Yeah. So one medicine destroys the disease, another medicine will do nothing. So what is that medicine?
Jedan lijek uništava bolest, a drugi lijek neće ništa koristiti.
Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
And service to the Vaishnavas.
I služenje Vaishnava.
Because if you're chanting Hare Krishna and you're not serving Vaishnavas, your chanting won't go very far at all.
Jer ako mantrate Hare Krishna a ne služite Vaishnava, nećete baš jako daleko dobriti s time.
And third one is Jivadoya.
Treća uputa je Jiva Doja.
Take responsibility to give Krishna consciousness to others.
Preuzmite odgovornost da drugima date svjesnost Krishne.
And then you're recognized by Krishna directly.
I onda će vas Krishna osobno uočiti.
Thank you.
Hvala.
Pitanje? Hare Krishna.
Higher
position in the Krishna consciousness is higher responsibility.
Ali
so guru, previše ljubazni prema ženama, to nije
dobro niti za njih, niti za žene.
If gurus are too kind towards ladies, it's not so good neither for them nor for the ladies.
Ali imamo gure koji su
introvertne
prirode.
But we have some gurus who are introvert types.
Pa sa tim i ređe ljubazni ili manje pokazuju te osobine.
And therefore they don't appear so kind, they don't show so display so much such characteristics.
Kako mi duhovne duše u ženskom telu da zauzmemo pravilni stav, da ne budemo zbunjene i kako da se u skladu s tim i ponašamo.
What would be the proper attitude we souls in the female body should have in order to behave properly in such situations?
You're asking about what is the attitude of a
female
devotee. Some gurus are too kind and it's not good for them and the ladies, and some gurus are not at all responsive to ladies' presence, right?
Neki guru su previše ljubazni i sa damama i to nije dobro ni za njih ni za dame, a neki su previše zatvoreni i onda ništa ne izražavaju.
Yeah, there is the middle road.
Da, postoji i taj srednji put.
Our philosophy is that kindness may be shown in different ways.
Naša filozofija da se ljubaznost može pokazati na različite načine.
The highest form of kindness is to give spiritual knowledge and guidance.
Najveći oblik ljubaznosti je pružiti osobama duhovno vodstvo, upute.
So some gurus focus exclusively on that.
I neki se guruju usredotočuju isključivo na to.
Other are more personal.
A drugi su osobniju.
Not that others are not personal, but they express their personal relationship in different ways.
Ne da su oni prvi impersonalni, da nisu osobe, nego tu svoju osobnost pokazuju na drugačiji način.
But there is an extreme in both cases.
Postoje krajnosti, u jednom drugom slučaju su krajnosti.
too much and not enough.
Previše i nedovoljno.
So your question is, how should the ladies see this?
To je pitanje kako da žene to vide. What could be the proper attitude and behavior of the souls in female bodies in accordance with the different characteristics of different gurus?
The behavior, I think, is a general thing. That just to be respectful.
Ponašanje može se reći općenita stvar, jednostavno treba biti pod poštovanjem.
If you're expecting something and you don't get it, then maybe may cause you unhappy or may actually be maya.
A ako nešto očekuješ a to ne dobiješ, to može te učiniti nesretnom ili može biti jednostavno maya.
Prabhupada was both.
Prabhupada je imao jednu i drugu osobinu.
He could be very personal and kind, even to his lady disciples, and at the same time he could be very aloof and transcendental to women in general.
Mogao je biti vrlo ljubazan u ophođenju sa svojim učenicama, a s druge strane mogao pokazati da je jako transcendentalan i udaljen od žena općenito.
So I think you just have to accept that people are different.
Jednostavno trebaš prihvatiti da su ljudi različiti.
And rather than expecting something, your role is to more or less see what you could give.
I umjesto da nešto očekuješ od njih, jednostavno trebaš sagledati što je to što im možeš pružiti.
I gave this lecture, I gave this comment came up in Mayapur when I was giving a talk in Mayapur.
Dok sam u Mayapuru držao predavanje, nešto se govorilo o tome.
How to relate to different types of devotees.
Kako se obhoditi sa različitim vrstama bhakta.
So either in a male body or in a female body, when it comes to senior devotees, there's two principles that you follow.
Bilo da si u ženskom tijelu ili u muškom tijelu, tu su dva načela koje treba slijediti.
Or there's two ways you can serve them.
Dva načina na koji možeš služiti.
By hearing from them.
Slušajući što govore.
To be eager to hear from senior devotees is a type of service. It is. It's a very high form of service.
Žarko žudjeti za time da čuješ to što stariji bhakte govore je jedan oblik služenja, vrlo uzvišeni oblik služenja.
Senior devotees come to speak.
Stariji bhakte dolaze da bi govorili.
And the more eager people are to hear, the more they're eager to speak.
I što ljudi koji su u publici više žarko žele čuti to što oni govore, to su oni više spremni govoriti.
So when you're eager to hear, that's a very good quality.
Tako da ako žarko želiš slušati, to je
by offering something like cooking or doing washing clothes or doing something personal.
Kao što je kuhanje ili za njih ili pranje odjeće ili nešto tako.
And some gurus allow ladies and others don't.
Neki guru dozvoljavaju da to čine dame, a neki ne.
So you can do indirect personal service for those who don't come in contact with ladies so much.
Sa onima koji ne dolaze neposredno u dodir sa ženama, sa damama, njih možeš posredno služiti.
So if you think maybe I can, I'll make something, I'll cook it, I'll give it to his servant will give it to him, and that's fine.
Na primjer, nešto ću pripremiti, nešto ću kuhati, nešto ću dati njegovom slugi, a on će dati njemu i to je.
Or you could give a personal gift.
Ili može dati neki poklon baš za njega na taj način.
Or, you know, just think of ways you can do some service and Krishna let Krishna inspire you that way.
Ili ako jednostavno razmišljaš da želiš na neki način služiti tu osobu, Krishna će te nadahnuti.
But if you're eager to get attention from your service, that might be a problem.
Ali ako zapravo žudiš za time da te primijete kao za uzvrat za tu službu, da te ta osoba primijeti, to je onda može biti problem.
Some will say thank you.
Neki od njih će se zahvaliti.
And some will say they'll accept your service, they'll thank you within their heart, but there'll be no personal contact.
Neki će prihvatiti tvoju službu, zahvalit će ti u srcu, ali neće biti osobne interakcije.
So you can expect there being different types of reciprocation. according, but within a certain boundary of acceptability. When we go too much on each side, it could be like there's some material conditions that have entered there. Like too much friendliness with ladies is not, as you said, it's not good for the ladies, it's not good for the guru.
Ako ima, ako postoje krajnosti u tom odnosu, onda to ukazuje da se unutra ugla neka materijalna uvjetovanost, kao što si ti rekla, ako je osoba previše prijateljski naklonjena prema osobama u ženskom tijelu, ovo je muškom, onda to je nešto, nije dobro biti za, kao što si ti rekla, za dame, niti za njega.
If there's no if respect is not there, friendliness is useless.
Mislim da ako ne postoji poštovanje, onda je prijateljstvo beskorisno.
Respect has to be there in all relationships.
U svim odnosima mora postojati poštovanje.
Thank you. Any other questions?
Još neko pitanje?
Yes, Prabhu. Da,
kada je ta mlada pitao da li želimo ići odavde, ja sam digao ruku da ne želim,
when you asked whether we want to leave this place, then I raised up my hand, indicating that I don't want to leave it, because if I wanted it, that would mean that I am Krishna conscious.
That means if you...
I could have already been Krishna conscious. Therefore, I don't want it.
You don't want to leave?
Ne želiš otići?
Ako bi želio, već bi bio svjestan Krišne.
If I wanted that, I would have been Krishna, already Krishna conscious.
Oh, I see, then. We're not asking for humble statements.
Ja nisam tražio neke ponizne izjave.
You want to go or not?
Hoćeš ići nećeš.
I mean, okay. Lord Chaitanya. Someone said to Lord Chaitanya, you're such a wonderful devotee. You have so much love for Krishna.
Netko rekao gospodinu Chaitanya, ti si tako predivan bhakta, imaš toliko puno ljubavi prema Krišni.
Lord Chaitanya says that I have no love for Krishna.
Gospodin Chaitanya rekao, nemam uopće ljubavi prema Krišni.
And because I have no love for Krishna, I can show you, because I'm still trying to maintain this body, it means I have no love for Krishna.
Činjenica da još uvijek održavam na životu ovo tijelo pokazuje da ne osjećam nikakvu ljubav prema Krišni.
But he has a lot of love for Krishna.
On zapravo puno ljubavi ima prema Krišni. To je Radharanina ljubav.
But what he's saying is that this is the ultimate principle of love, that one, you know, doesn't want to do anything to maintain himself in this world anymore. When you get to that stage, yeah.
Ali ono što pokazuje sa time odgovorom je da postoji taj uzvišeni stupanj u kojem osoba više ne želi učiniti ništa da bi se održala u ovom svijetu, pa čak i održala tijelo.
But that's not our problem.
To nije naš problem.
We should maintain the body.
Mi trebamo održavati tijelo.
To serve Krishna nicely.
Da bismo mogli lijepo služiti Krishna.
To spread Krishna consciousness.
Da bismo mogli širiti svjesnost Krishna.
To assist Prabhupada in bringing Krishna consciousness to different places in the world.
Da bismo pomagali Prabhupadu u širenju svjesnosti Krišne na različita mjesta diljem svijeta.
That is as good as being not in the world anymore.
A takvo djelovanje je jednako dobro kao da više i nisi u ovom svijetu.
But my question was, does anybody want to stay here?
Ali moje pitanje je zapravo bilo, ima li nikoga tko bi ovdje htio ostati?
I mean, some of us do, but not talking, not telling me.
Neki možda i žele to, ali neki ne žele to sad reći.
Croatia has nice beaches.
Hrvatska ima lijepe plaže.
The warm weather is coming, it's going to get nicer.
Kad se zatopli, onda je ljepše.
Not so bad.
Nije tako loše.
I'm still young.
Još sam mlad.
When I look in the mirror, I still see how beautiful I am.
Kad se pogledam u ogledalo, još vidim kako sam lijep.
So, you know, we get illusioned by what's happening.
Tako nas obmane sve to što se događa.
So we want to get out of this place.
Zapravo želimo otići odavde.
It's a miserable place.
To mjesto puno
Krishna says over and over. Can't you understand? Krishna says, this place is miserable.
To Krišna stalno ponavlja, zar ne razumijete? Stalno kaže, ovo mjesto krca to bjeda.
When we understand what is happiness, you understand what is misery.
Kada razumijemo što je sreća, onda možemo tek shvatiti što je bjeda.
You don't know happiness. And misery looks like happiness.
Kad ne poznajete pravu sreću, onda bjeda izgleda kao sreća.
A person who gets drunk, he thinks he's happy, but when you look at him, you say, this guy's really miserable, right?
Kada se netko napije, on misli da je sretan, ali kad ga vi pogledate, mislite, ovo je stvarno jadan.
So you know, he's miserable, he's thinking I'm happy.
Vi znate da je jadan, a on misli za sebe da je sretan.
So there's different degrees of experiencing happiness, but if unless we know what is a little bit about transcendental happiness, we'll think, this world's not so bad.
Ali postoje različiti stupnjevi doživlja sreće, ali ako ne znamo bar nešto o transcendentalnoj sreći, možemo zaključiti da u ovom svijetu nije tako loše.
Story.
Quick
one. Ah, ne, priča, kratka priča. Thank you. She's good. She should give the class and I'll do the translation. There's a man, he's blind, he has no children, and he's poor.
Čovjek je slep, nema djece i siromašan.
So he meets a sadhu.
I susretne sadhu.
And he does some service for the sadhu.
I služi ga.
Sadhu is very powerful.
Sadhu je jako moćan.
Sadhu says, I'll give you any benediction you want.
I sadhu kaže, daću ti koji god blagoslov poželiš.
I can make you rich, I can give you children, or I can give you your eyesight back. You choose one.
Možeš da biti jedan blagoslov, ili da se obogatiš, ili da dobiješ natrag vid, ili da dobiješ djecu.
Which one would you choose?
Koji biste vi izabrali?
Don't answer. He says, I choose that I want to see my children while I'm standing on top of my palace.
Želim vidjeti svoju djecu dok stojim na vrhu svoje palače.
That's Krishna consciousness.
To je svjesnost.
You get it all in one shot.
Jednim udarcem sve dobijete.
Whatever you're looking for, you can find it by becoming Krishna conscious.
Sve za čime tragate možete dobiti tako što postanete svjesni
Krishna. And whatever you don't need, you don't get.
A ono što vam ne treba, to nećete dobiti.
So we want to get out of this place.
Želimo otići odavde.
We don't want to stay, because life with Krishna is life.
Ne želimo ovdje ostati, zato jer je pravo život moj sa Krishna.
What about my family?
A što s mojom obitelji?
I love my
family. Volim svoju obitelj.
But which family are you talking about? This life? Or the one in the last life? Or the life before? Which one are you talking about? Who's your father?
Ko ti otac?
Who's your children?
Ko su ti djeca?
This life?
Ovaj život?
Next life?
Sljedeći
last
život?
Life?
Prošli život?
Which one's the real mother, father?
Koja majka je prava? Koji otac je pravi?
It's like every life we get a whole new circumstance and think, ah, this is it.
Svaki život dobimo novi set okolnosti, mislimo, ha, to je to.
We keep changing.
Zapravo stalno mijenjamo.
But our relationship with Krishna never changes.
Ali naš odnos sa Krishnom se nikad ne mijenja.
Because that's the reality.
Jer to je stvarnost.
This world is always changing.
Ovaj svijet se stalno mijenja.
You want to know one thing in this world that is constant?
Želite znati za jednu stvar u ovom svijetu koja je trajna, konstanta?
Called change.
Zove se promjena.
It's the only constant thing in this world is change.
Jedina konstantna, trajna stvar u ovom svijetu, promjena.
So keep changing until you reach the place where you don't change anymore.
Nastavite s promjenama sve dok ne dođete na mjesto u kojem više nema promjena.
That's what we want. We want to come to a place where we don't have to change anymore.
To je to što želimo. Želimo doći na mjesto na kojem više nećemo se morati mijenjati.
And that's with Krishna.
A to mjesto je sa Krishnom.
Okay. All right, any other questions? Criticisms?
Još neko pitanje ili kritika?
Statements of retraction?
Nešto što sam previše rekao?
Lawsuits? No?
Tužbe.
Okay. Thank you very much. It's not over yet. Okay, here we go. Bring in the prasadam. Okay. We got some sweets.
Imamo slatkiše.
These are transcendental.
Transcendentalni slatkiši.
Srila Prabhupada ki.
Jai.
Srisi Gaudiya ki.
Jai.
Jagannath Baladeva Subhadra Maharani ki.
Jai.
Gaura Premanande.
Hari
Prabhu Shangadeva ki. Thank you, Mother Vinata. Thank you, Mother Vinata ki. This, the wrap so nice.
This chesty, oh, this chesty.
Don't eat it.
Yeah, piece of it.
Samo znam koji
sam. To sam stavio.
Samo znam koji sam. Chesty.